Hi there. In this video, we'll learn how to airbrush skin non-destructively in Photoshop. So let's get started. I have this image opened in Photoshop already, and let me tell you that it was a very tiny image and I had to resize it to make it look like what it is now. First of all, let's make two copies of this layer. And for that, let's right-click this layer and select Duplicate Layer option from the drop-down. Let's rename it Details. Now, right-click the layer once again and select the Convert to Smart Object option, which will make this layer non-destructive, which means all the settings applied to this layer can easily be removed without affecting the layer. Let's unlock the background layer by clicking this lock icon on top of the layers panel, and then right-click the background layer once again and select the duplicate layer option to make another copy of the layer. This time, let's rename the layer Softness and hit OK. Also, much like earlier, right-click the Softness layer and convert it to a Smart Object. So now we have three layers, background, softness, and details. And the top two layers have been converted to smart objects. Select the details layer, which is sitting at the top, and go to filter, and then other, and select high pass from here. High pass works by filling the entire image with flat neutral gray. It then looks for edges in the image, basically the areas with an abrupt change in brightness between neighboring pixels, and highlights them by making the light side of the edge lighter and the dark side darker. Non-edge areas remain flat gray. So here I'm going to keep the radius around 3 pixels, in which I can barely see any details of the image, and hit OK. Also, change the blending mode of this layer to Linear Light. Linear Light burns or dodges the colors by decreasing or increasing the brightness depending on the blend color. If the blend color or the light source is lighter than 50% gray, the image is lightened by increasing the brightness. If the blend color is darker than 50% gray, the image is darkened by decreasing the brightness. Alright, we've done enough to the details layer. It's time to touch the softness layer, so let's select it and head to filter and then blur and select Gaussian blur from the drop down. Here we need to adjust the radius to the point where the skin looks cleaner. So for this image, I'll keep it to 24.7 pixels. Let me also tell you here that this would depend entirely up to your image, so perhaps it would need a bigger or a smaller pixel. So don't just stick to 24.7 if you're using this method with one of your images. Let's hit OK to come out of Gaussian blur. Next, holding Command on a Mac or Control on a PC, select the top two layers, which are details and softness, and then right-click and select Group from Layers option. Rename the layer should you want. I'll keep it untouched and hit OK. With the grouped layer selected, add an inverted layer mask to the group by holding Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC and clicking the Add Layer Mask button at the bottom of the layers panel. You'll find a black mask appearing next to the grouped layer folder. It's black because we inverted it holding Option or Alt. Now we need to ensure that the foreground color is white and then pick the brush tool and ensure it's a soft brush. Now slowly and carefully brush the skin to remove the pigmentation marks. This step will need your time and complete attention, and you may even need to adjust the brush size to brush the edges. Remember, to increase the brush size, you need to press the right bracket, and to reduce it, you need to press the left bracket. You see the edges here have turned gray, so to correct this, all we need to do is change the foreground color from white to black, and brush to get it corrected. And that's the best part about using a mask. The image remains non-destructive. Once you're done airbrushing the image, if you feel it's looking a little plastic, you can always reduce the opacity and it will improve your image. For this image, we don't really need to reduce it, so I'm gonna stick to 100. Let's now click the Create a New Layer button at the bottom of the Layers panel to add a new layer, and then rename it Eyes. Ensure that the foreground color is white, and since mine is not, I am going to click it and change it to white and hit OK. Let's also change the blending mode of this layer to overlay. Now, using the soft brush, brush around the eyelids. Don't worry if the image looks odd at this point. We can always adjust the intensity of this by reducing the opacity. So for this one, let's reduce the opacity to about 34%. Now, let's add a hue and saturation layer from the bottom of the layers panel and change the blending mode to soft light. Play with the hue and saturation settings to your liking. For our image here, we don't really need to make a lot of adjustments here. Now I'm going to add another layer and rename it Lips. Double click the foreground color and pick a color of your choice. I'm going to pick a shade of red and hit OK. Now I'm going to slowly and carefully brush the lips, ensuring I don't mistakenly brush outside of the lips region. Although even if I did that, it could very easily be corrected by changing the foreground color to black and then brushing for correction. Once the lips are covered with the red color, let's change the blending mode to soft light. You can always try other blending options to see how they look and then pick the one you like the most. Lastly, we'll add another layer and rename it Spot Removal. Now I'm going to pick the Spot Healing Brush tool and also change the foreground color to white, although it does not make a difference since we're not brushing on a mask. So let's brush to clear any spots to perfect the image further. Please ensure that you don't overdo this. And also ensure that the shadows and midtones do not get affected by the healing brush. Otherwise, the image will start to look clumsy. So, this is the original image. And this is after we airbrushed it using the necessary tools. And the best part is that it is completely non-destructive. Do let me know what you think about this in the comments. Alright guys, that concludes our session today. I hope there was something for you to take away from this video. So if you enjoyed it, do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Until we meet again, goodbye and thanks for watching.